Welcome to Sri Guru Gita, commentary on the mysteries of the guru-disciple relationship. This commentary is written by Paramahamsa Vishwananda and narrated by Paramahamsa Vishwananda, Swami Revatikaanta, and Danta Dasananda. Paramahamsa Sri Swami Vishwananda gives this introduction to his commentary.
The guru bhakti is very important. You know, in all tradition, you see that how the guru is important. You see, in the Skanda Puran, Vyasa wrote a lot about the greatness of the master. Adi Shankaracharya himself said, all the worship, all the praises without the grace of the master is useless. Narsimha said also similar, singing the praise of the Lord, but if you don't have the grace of the master, you don't have the grace of the guru, all is go wasted. Mahavatar Babaji himself said, you know, to Lahir Mashaya, for the grace which you transfer to the people, I shall give the blessing. But without the blessing, nothing work. Same thing with Christ. He blessed his disciple, sending them, saying, to whom you will bless, I shall bless. To those to you, you reject the blessing, you curse them, I shall also devour them from that blessing. So meaning that the transfer, the blessing which one received, is far almost very ancient. It's a lineage tracing itself till you. In the Guru Gita, which is part of the Skanda Puran, there's praises which Vyasa wrote. Skanda Puran is one of the Puranas out of the 18 Puranas, which is the praises and how one have to open up the heart to receive the grace. Normally there is 400 verses in the Guru Gita. But we will discuss only the main one, which is 182. So you have to bear with me a little bit. So the Guru Gita was a discussion between Shankar and Parvati. Now, where Goddess Parvati ask Shiva, who do you consider the greatest on earth? And Lord Shiva himself, in the form of Dakshinamurti, explained to Mahadevi that the greatest form which I consider on earth is the form of the master. And as in the Gita, Krishna himself said, I am the embellishment of the guru. It is through my grace that the guru appeared on earth. And it is through my grace that the disciple are guided to where they belong. Christ himself said, you know, I have come for my sheep. I have come for my flocks. So wherever one is, the guru will search, will attract the disciple. So the Guru Gita is one of the song which is the most wonderful.
Om Premavataraya Vidmahe Satguru Devaya Dhimahi Tanno Vishwananda Prachodayat. Om Premavataraya Vitmahe Satguru Devaya Dhimahi Tanno Vishwananda Prachodayat. Om Premavataraya Vitmahe Satguru Devaya Dhimahi Tanno Vishwananda Prachodayat. Om Asya Shri Guru Gita Stotra Mantrasya Bhagavan Sadashiva Rishi Nana Vidhani Chandamsi Shri Guru Paramatma Devata Ham Bijam Sa Shaktihi Krom Kilakam Shri Guru Kripa Siddhyarte Jape Viniyogaha Ata Dhyanam Ham Sabhyam Parivratta Patra Kamaler Divyer Jagat Karane Vishvot Kirnam Maneka Dehanilaye Svachandamat Mechaya Tadyotam Padashambhavam Tucharanam Deepankura Grahinam Pratyakshakshara Vigraham Gurupadam Dhyayed Vibhum Shashvatam Mama Chaturveda Purushartha Siddhyarte Jape Viniyogaha.
Verse 1.
Suta Uvacha Kailasa Shikare Ramye Bhakti Sandana Nayakam Pranamya Parvati Bhaktya Shankaram Paryapritchata.
Sage Sukha replied, this is a talk, a great sage, which is the explaining. Once, while Lord Shiva, who knows the secret of devotion, here we have to note that the secret of devotion is known through the sadhana. And Lord Shiva is considered to be the greatest of all sadhaka, because he's in constant meditation. He's always meditating on Narayana, because all come from Narayana. So Lord Shiva, because of his devotion, because of his submerge into his sadhana, that's why in this verse it said that the one who knows the secret of devotion, because devotion is not just plain. There is deepness into it, even if it appeared very plain, very. Sometimes, you know, you will have devotion, you don't feel much. You know, you are praying, you said, oh, my prayer is mechanical. But in reality, no, it is not. Because the uttering, even the chanting of the divine names, is not just merely a straight line. It is in deepness. It has its depth. And its depth is cleansing the impurity which have carried through many lives. So here Bhagavan Shankar is saying that he is the one who knows that deepness, the secret of devotion. Because he's fully submerged into that bhakti. He's fully submerged into that devotion. He's fully absorbed into that devotion. Being absorbed into that devotion, meaning he's enjoying bhakti. Because if somebody is not absorbed into one's devotion, meaning that one is bored about it. And when one gets bored about something, they are not absorbed into it. But if you know the secret which lies behind that what you are doing, you will love to do it. That's why when you love to do something...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.